Lecture 8 in academic writing, sentences beginning with it, special verb tenses in that clothes, if where the clothes, question clothes. Objectives: clarify sentences beginning with it, define special verb tenses in that clothes, define if where the clothes, question clothes. Plan of the lecture: sentences beginning with it, special verb tenses in that clothes, if where the clothes, question clothes. A noun clause is the dependent clause that functions as a noun. A noun clause is often part of an independent clause, where it can be a subject or an object. A noun clause can also follow certain adjectives and nouns. There are three kinds of noun clauses: that clauses, which begin with the word that, if whether clauses, which begin with the words whether or if, question clauses, which begin with the question word, such as who, what, where, when, or how. A that clause is a dependent noun clause that begins with the word that. The young filmmaker hopes that his film will be a financial success. A that clause can appear in different locations. After the independent clause, verb, the most common position of a noun clause is after the verb of the independent clause, where it functions as the object of that verb. After certain adjectives, a that clause can also follow certain adjectives, such as happy, glad, proud, pleased, sad, upset, worried, sorry, certain, surprised, and sure. After certain nouns, a that clause can follow certain nouns such as idea, theory, thought, claim, statement, belief, notion, and opinion. At the beginning of a sentence, a that clause at the beginning of a sentence functions as the subject of the independent clause verb. So let's talk about sentences beginning with it. Starting a sentence with a noun clause seems awkward to many English speakers, so they often rewrite such sentences by putting it at the beginning and moving the noun clause to the end. For example, that Earth is getting warmer is certain. It is certain that Earth is getting warmer. In addition, the verb following it, except be or any intransitive verb like seem or appear, is often written in the passive voice, especially in academic writing. For example, it was agreed that the meeting would be postponed until next week. You can also write these sentences in the active voice. The participants agreed that the meeting would be postponed until next week. In general, English writers prefer the active voice because it is more direct. However, they prefer the passive voice in five specific situations. You want to emphasize what happened, not who did it. Jack was promoted last month. The performer of the action is unknown. One of the most common uses of noun clauses in academic writing is to report what someone else has said or written. This kind of noun clause is called reported speech or indirect quotation. Verb tenses in reported speech follow special rules. If the main clause verb is simple present perfect or future, the verb in the noun clause is in the tense that expresses the meaning that the main clause intends. The prime ministers agree that global warming is a serious world problem. They hope that all nations will be responsible for solving this problem. If the main clause verb is in the past tense, the verb in the noun clause is usually in a past form. The prime minister agreed that global warming was a serious world problem. The verb in the noun clause stays in the present tense when it reports a fact or a general truth. Researchers in the field verified that icebergs and glaciers are melting. So let's talk about if weather clauses. An if weather clause is a dependent noun clause that begins with the subordinator whether or if. Whether is more formal than if. The optional phrase or not may be added in two places with whether and in one place with if. Therefore, there are five possible patterns. Look at these examples, please. Notice that if weather clauses are statements, not questions. Even though they are made from yes-no questions, questions that can be answered yes or no, if weather clauses use statement, word, order, subject, verb, and do not contain do, does, or did, to change a question into an if weather clause, add a subordinator, if or whether, change the word order to statement word order, and delete do, does, and did it necessary. So let's talk about question clauses. A question clause is a dependent noun clause that begins with a subordinator such as who, what, when, where, why, how much, how long, and so on. There are two possible patterns. In the first pattern, the subordinator is the subject of the clause. The police do not know who committed the robbery. In the second pattern, the subordinator is not the subject of the clause. The police do not know when the robbery happened. Notice that the word order in question clauses is statement order, subject plus verb, not question order, verb plus subject. Also, question clauses do not contain do, does, or did because they are not questions, even though they begin with a question word. To change a question into a question clause, change the word order to statement word order and delete do, does, and did if necessary. Question: what time is it? Sentence with question clause: please tell me what time is it? How did the robbers enter the apartment? The police want to know how did the robbers enter the apartment. Follow the sequence of tenses, rules if necessary. If the independent clause verb is in a past tense, the verb in the noun clause should also be in a past tense. The victims did not know how the robbers had entered the apartment. So, let's talk about parallelism in sentences. They refer to matching grammatical structures. Elements in a sentence that have the same function or express similar ideas should be grammatically parallel or grammatically matched. Parallelism is used as a rhetorical and stylistic device in literature, speeches, advertising, and popular songs. Parallel structure or parallelism means using the same pattern of words that show that two or more words or ideas are of equal importance. Words and phrases should not only match in structure, but also in tense. Writers use parallel structure to add clarity to their writing and to make it easier to understand. It also adds value to a writer's overall composition and shows that their writing is structurally and grammatically correct. Writers use parallel structure in the words that in phrases in their sentences. This grammatical form can be used with a variety of structures including infinitives, words, clauses and lists. Parallel structure should be used when you connect clauses with the coordinating conjunctions such as for, and, nor, or, but, so, or yet. Parallel structure should be used when it comes to verb tense. Your verb tenses should always match. Some examples include, for example, she wrote a letter and mailed it to the school. It will be correct. She writes a letter and mailed it to the school. It's incorrect. Correct. Yesterday we watched a movie, played video games and made pizza. Incorrect. Yesterday we watched a movie, played video games and made pizza. Parallel structure provides flow in a sentence. It keeps your writing balanced and makes it easier to read. It also shows that ideas are of equal importance. Errors in parallel structure errors can make your writing sound strange to listeners. Many tests, including, will require you to identify parallel structure errors as a means of testing your writing abilities. So let's talk about important points covered in this lecture. First, a noun clause is a dependent clause that acts like a noun. For example, John asked a question. And John asked which chapter the exam would cover. Second, a noun clause can act as a subject, an object, or a subject complement. That clauses can also follow certain adjectives and nouns. The most common position of a noun clause is after the verb of the main independent clause. Starting a sentence with a noun clause is awkward. English speakers usually rewrite these sentences so that they begin with it and end with the noun clause. That the professor cancelled the exam surprised us. It surprised us that the professor cancelled the exam. Whether the professor will cancel the exam is uncertain. Passive voice is often used in these kinds of sentences, especially in academic writing. It was once believed by many that Earth was flat. When a noun clause reports what someone asked or said, you must follow the sequence of tenses rules for reported speech. Following verbs and adjectives indicating urgency, necessity, use the base form of the verb in the noun clause. This kind of noun clause is called a subjunctive noun clause. It is necessary that students be on time for the final exam. Noun clauses use statement word order even when they begin with a question word. They also do not contain do, does, or did because they are not questions. Commas are not used with noun clauses. So, questions you have to answer. What is one of the most common uses of noun clauses in academic writing? What is a question clause? Are if whether clauses questions? Why do English writers prefer the active voice? And how will you change a question to a question clause? And sources you can use in order to prepare for your practical lessons. So, the lesson is over.